Hi, I'm Dr. Mandell. I'm here to help you with your many questions that you have regarding your neck ailment, your pinched nerve, your radiculopathy, your neuritis. These are all basically nerves that are inflamed, irritated, causing muscles to contract and having symptoms coming from the neck. Nerves play a lot of funny games. Not only can they cause referred pain, that means pain coming from a different area and having symptoms as well, but they can actually cause headaches, cause dizziness. They could affect our eyes. They can cause burning down the arm, into the hand, down the shoulder blade, even into the legs. The bottom line is, what are your options? What are you doing? What can you do? What should you do? That's the big question. With all the hundreds of comments and questions, as well as the videos out there today, this really should be the core of the question of pinched nerves and neck pain. The first thing you need to ask yourself is, how and where did this problem stem from? How long have you had it? What caused the problem? Is it getting better? Is it getting worse? Is it inflamed? Are you losing motor strength? Are the muscles getting weaker? Did you lose reflexes? There's a lot of correlation with nerves. Understand that the nerves that come out of the neck are the nerves that affect the brachial plexus. This is the group of nerves that go down the shoulder into the arm and hands. Nerves play a lot of funny games. There are bulging discs. There are herniated discs. The question here is, where is the problem stemming from? Now, I say that with respect, because as soon as a clinician or physician sees an MRI scan, and they say, wow, you have a bulging disc C5, C6. You have a herniated disc C6, C7. You have another herniated disc C7, T1. And the first thing that happens is everyone panics. Well, what do I do? Well, you need to see the surgeon. You need to get the epidural. Now, all I can tell you is that you need to be certain that there's no nerve root damage. There's no compression against the spinal cord that's causing neurological deficit. The reflexes are normal. The motor strength is normal. That is the key thing. That's the most important thing. First is that you do not have neurological deficit. Now, nerves take a long time to repair. It takes a short time to hurt them, but a long time to repair. Also understand that usually when people experience disc-related conditions, they're usually chronic in nature, meaning that there's something that's been underlying, then all of a sudden, one day, the tip of the iceberg, which is the pain, arises. At that moment, you start having symptoms, but realize that your symptoms are usually the last thing to come and the first thing to go away. When problems occur in the cervical spine, the nerves that exit between the vertebrae at the disc level, you have 8 cervical nerves. And generally the most common problem of herniated discs or bulging discs are in the middle of the neck. The neck has a normal C-shaped lordotic curve going inwards. And as it goes inwards, that is designed to help stabilize the weight of the head being 12 pounds at the facet joints. When the curve becomes straightened, they call that a kyphosis or a straightening of the normal cervical curve. All the pressure and the weight of the head is now being compressed on the disc levels. That's why degeneration occurs, and degeneration is always usually silent. So as degeneration continues to occur, one day, at that point when the straw that broke the camel's back, that's when the symptoms start to arise. Now, understand that a lot of degeneration occurs mostly from bad posture, pronated shoulders, shoulders that go forward, the head that is in an anterior translation or anterior position for long periods of time, looking down, typing, maybe on the phone, on the computer, texting, whatever you're doing. Make sure that you have the ears always in line with the shoulders. When there's too forward, it's going to put excessive stress on the muscles, ligaments, and joints, causing more inflammation, causing more instability in the joints, causing those joints to degenerate and have more arthritic changes, which we call degenerative joint disease or arthritis. So the first line of defense when it comes to any inflammation of the body is always use ice. Ice, 10, 15 minutes, take an ice pack, a bag of peas, frozen food, whatever you want to do. But take the ice, put it over the side of the neck where you feel it's stemming from, even though you may have pain down the arm, but know that the cause is coming from the neck. You want to treat the neck area. By putting ice on the arm is not going to correct the inflammation from where it's coming from. Now, when there's compression and irritation from the neck, that area that's being compressed or irritated is the site of origin. The pain is actually the site of the referred pain coming from that site. So make sure you know where the exact etiology or the cause of your problem is stemming from, so you know how to treat it properly. And again, you may not be the one to make that diagnosis. So get the professional help or ask the right questions to someone who is competent that can give you some good advice. Now, there are many different routes to go as well. Massage therapy, chiropractic, medicine, surgery. Obviously, I always recommend to take the least invasive route first. Remember this. If you have a fly swatter and you can kill the fly with the fly swatter, don't use the sledgehammer. And I say that with respect to your body. If you can do something conservative, meaning ice, proper therapy, physical therapy, chiropractic, massage therapy, proper stretches, working with proper ergonomics, good posture, good strengthening, where you can strengthen the rhomboid muscles between the shoulder blades to make sure the shoulders are back. You can stretch the chest muscles so you're not rounding forward, and doing the right things, and you can use that as your ammunition. I can promise you that the majority of your cases will get well all naturally. It's when you continue to do things incorrectly, all the wrong things, like smoking and drinking and not getting enough sleep and being under stress, that's not good for your health. But if you're not carrying the right posture and you're not doing the right things for your postural health, your condition will continue to linger on. Now, if you take the medicine route, like the ibuprofens, the Motrin, the Advil, the naproxen, the Aleve, and other muscle relaxers, as well as painkillers, what you're doing is kind of like walking on something sharp on your feet and not feeling it. So what I'm saying is, if this is taking away the pain and taking away the problem, but you keep exacerbating it and you're not feeling it, your body's alarm system is not going off. It's not giving you the warning to beware and take proper precautions. So if you keep doing the wrong things, you're going to keep getting the wrong results, and you're going to wonder why your problem's not going away. If you take an x-ray, x-rays will only show hard tissue. An MRI will show soft tissue. So in order to see an exact diagnosis of a herniated disc, you need to take an MRI. Do not let a physician or any other clinician tell you that you have any disc problem by looking at an x-ray. I think that was great advice, because I hear that all the time. Also, even if the MRI shows that there's a positive problem or a problem that you have, how do you know that you have not had that problem for years? So just because that problem is addressed, the surgeon will go right to that site, correct that site, and unfortunately, you're going to be living with pain the rest of your life, because that's not necessarily where the problem is coming from. So a good physician to make the right diagnosis and the right prognosis by doing the right thing at the right time for you is extremely important for your health and your well-being. Another thing that comes up quite often is epidurals. Well, my opinion on epidurals, because I've had them myself and I've been to the best of the neurosurgeons around, the good neurosurgeons tell you to stay away from them if possible. Again, I am not here to make diagnoses or prognoses or opinions for you, but all I can say is that you need to beware, because there are many complications that can occur when a needle is being put, a big needle is being put near the spinal cord. So that's something I wanted to share with you as well. So I hope that this was thorough thorough enough to where you can get a good understanding more about your disc, your pinched nerve, your cervical problem, and understand that postural position is extremely critical. That causes the majority of wear and tear in the body, and the majority of inflammation, the majority of disc problems are all related, majority, to bad posture, bad ergonomics, chronic day after day after day. So watch what you're doing, watch your position, tuck the chin in, get out of the habit of putting your head in a forward position for long periods of time. Be very aware of your body. Sleep on your back or your side, stay off your stomach, keep a knees bent. The knees bent if you're on your side with a pillow between the knees. If you're on your back, put a pillow underneath the knees, knees slightly bent, good for the back and spine. When you're sitting down, make sure you have a good support pillow behind your lower back. By putting a pillow behind your back, helps bring the shoulders back and the alignment back into the head and the neck. So people that do a lot of driving, a lot of sitting at desks, because of the poor stability of the lower back, the lumbar spine, that in itself is causing the neck area to hold up a lot of stress and obviously a lot of wear and tear. So there you have it. If you have any questions or comments, and if I can help you, I'll be more than happy. But anyways, I hope that you can take this, move forward, and make some better rational decisions on your own, because it is your health. It is your lifeline and your future, and nothing is worse than having pain. I can relate to that. But anyways, I hope you make it a great day. And I'm Dr. Alan Mandell.